My name is Swati Patel. I'm an assistant professor at Oregon State University. I think it depends on how young. I think up until like high school, I did pretty well in my math classes, and I always like enjoyed logic puzzles and logic card games. So I grew up playing a lot of games that involved like mathematical thinking. But then when I got to college, it felt like it no longer felt like it came naturally to me, and that I really struggled with a lot of my math classes and had to put a lot of effort into them to feel like I was understanding things. I feel like I never actually really like definitively or actively decided I wanted to be a mathematician. I think it kind of just like happened naturally, or just by what I was doing or got interested in at various points in my life. So I started off as a biologist, and I was very interested in like ecology and evolutionary questions. And there was an advisor I wanted to work with, and he accepted students through a population biology program and an applied math program. But by the time I decided I wanted to apply, it was too late for me to apply to population biology. And so I ended up like applying to the applied math program, but I was terrified of going into an applied math program. And I was also like really surprised when I got in, but then I just decided to do it anyway. And ever since then, I kind of like naturally got more gravitated towards research questions that were mathematical in flavor, and just kept doing problems that I was interested in, and that years later led me into a math department. I work on modeling different kinds of population dynamics of living organisms. And a lot of what I do is focused around coupling equations that describe ecological interactions between species. So you can think about like predator and prey, for example, or a disease spreading in a population. I try to couple those kinds of dynamic equations to underlying evolution or adaptation equations that happen within a species. So an example would be if you're talking about a disease spreading, maybe that disease pathogen is also evolving in some way. So I like to try to build models that couple these different levels of processes. And then from those models, try to abstract like general principles about how evolution affects the population dynamics and vice versa. So that's has a lot of applications from like conservation to understanding infectious disease spread and ecosystems and some of my biggest struggles are centered around my inner critic. So it's this like voice inside me that sometimes tells me, oh, don't try that. You won't succeed. You're not good enough. I think it stems from growing up in an environment where I wasn't really like allowed to be wrong about things or allowed to make mistakes. And I think that stems from like a culture and generation of that I grew up in. So it's this kind of attitude that like kind of a negative attitude about oneself. And it makes navigating research very difficult, where there's so much uncertainty and there's always a lot you don't know. It's you have to get comfortable with being making mistakes and being wrong in this area or in this field. And I think it's like very mentally and emotionally exhausting to have that inner critic all the time. one of my biggest, I think, relates to this struggle was to shift my outlook on my own life and my relationship to my work. So a lot of my life, I felt like I was tying my self-worth to my accomplishments, like how many papers I was publishing or how many awards I won. I felt like those were the things I needed to be liked by the people around me. And that, again, I think that mentality kind of leads one to being unhappy in different ways. And so I felt like that was the case for me. And in graduate school, I went through therapy that was offered to me by my undergrad or graduate program. And it really helped me to like deal with some of that mentality and overcome it. And I think from that, the span of that time period that I was doing that, it led me to be much happier and have a more positive relationship to my work and just be more comfortable with who I was. So that was like a really important part of what I did in graduate school that I'm proud of. My second big accomplishment is now I'm raising a daughter, and I'm very much in the middle of this, so it's not like it's a completed thing. But I'm really proud of surrounding her with joy, love, and a safe place where she can be herself with no expectations. That's really important to me. This is a tough one for me. I feel like I always had advisors supporting me academically, but I think I was always like secretly intimidated by them and a little bit afraid to just be myself. And I think now I look more to my peers, so like other new professors or postdocs for support and guidance and inspiration on just how to be a better mathematician and how to be a better person. I love being in a profession where I can look at people around me and find so many that are like amazing at their jobs, but also just really awesome people. There's something that my ballet teacher in graduate school told me that really sticks with me and has always that I've always been like reminded of. And the words were, just get a little bit better every day. And I think what that means to me is to not worry so much about whether you're good enough or not at the moment, but just focus on putting in the work to just get a little bit better every day.